March, a jury has recommended 25 years behind bars for the woman that scammed two disabled veterans out of $20,000.
Now, prosecutors say it took less than 15 minutes for the jury to return with its guilty verdict. WLKY's Lauren Adams joins us now with what she learned from the family. And from what I understand talking to you, Lauren, they treated this woman like family, right?
Rick, you are absolutely right. And that's what makes this case so difficult moving forward. This woman was hired to help care for the father-son victims in this case. Family tells me they trusted her so much and were so pleased with the work she was doing that they, in fact, paid her 20% more than the other caregivers in the home. But for Cammie Henson, that wasn't enough.
It's despicable. It's despicable. It really is.
Virginia Browning's family is out $20,000. The woman hired to care for her disabled father-in-law and brother-in-law here at their home scammed the family out of thousands. Cammie Henson, convicted of abuse and neglect, was in charge of the pair's care and checkbook.
I came to think of her as a trusted friend, confidant. I really, really, really valued the friendship and the stuff that she did for us.
Henson, she says, emailed receipts of ATM withdrawals. She first noticed things weren't adding up back in April.
She would write on there charges for the foot doctor and charges for new glasses and charges for this other woman's time that was bogus, totally bogus.
Jack Browning Sr. never lived to see the case make it to the courts. The decorated Korean War vet and prisoner of war died in June. His son, Jack Jr., is a Vietnam vet who suffered devastating injuries in a motorcycle wreck. He's relieved at the jury's recommendation of 25 years behind bars.
He's a professional con artist.
Yes, turns out, yes.
It's why Franklin County Sheriff Pat Melton dedicated himself to helping convict the woman that scammed two disabled vets.
They give us the very rights and the freedom that we have, and then somebody to steal from them when they can't defend themselves laying in a bed. Horrible.
So it'll be ready tomorrow.
And while Browning might not ever get that $20,000 back, she believes prison time is worth more than a payout.
She's a predator. She's a predator, and I didn't want her to prey on anyone else.
As it turns out, Henson was previously convicted of stealing $40,000 from Baghdad Baptist Church. According to the sheriff, she was stealing from the Brownings to pay off the court restitution in that case. Lauren Adams, WLKY News.
Thank you, Lauren. Now, the jury, as we mentioned, has recommended a 25-year sentence in this case. Prosecutors believe the judge will follow that recommendation when Henson is formally sentenced in January. In the meantime, she'll remain in jail.